Fragrance in skincare. It's a hot topic. Dr. Dre talks often about fragrance in skincare. I've talked about fragrance in skincare. Hey, Dr. Dre, can we talk?
Can we talk? Can we talk?
Can we talk?
Hi skincare people, Custodio here again in the series You've Been Fooled. No, I'm not saying that Dr. Dre has been fooling us. I'm saying that you've been fooled sometimes by others, sometimes we are fooling ourselves. That's why this series tries to talk about ideas, shake them, and see if we all together understand more about skin in order to know more about skincare. So this video is a little bit different from all videos I've done in the past 2 months. Yes, I'm a very young YouTuber, even though I'm a very old man, but this channel I started 2 months ago. Of course, there are parts of other YouTubers in the information I'm putting up together with my personal experience working in the cosmetic industry for 30 years now. And Dr. Dre is a dermatologist I have followed and who I respect. Her content and her knowledge is not that all dermatologists necessarily know a lot about skincare formulation, but Dr. Dre does. Certainly, all dermatologists know a lot about skin and skin health and about ways to improve skin health, deal with pathogenics, but to know about skincare formulation, you need to have a certain passion for beauty, which definitely Dr. Dre does. And I really invite you, in case you don't know her channel, I will link the video I'm commenting on below. So the video in question is called Fragrance in Skincare, Am I a Fearmonger? It's Dr. Dre asking about herself, not me asking about myself. And in this video, Dr. Dre says something which I consider extremely wise, extremely interesting, which I felt like sharing with you guys. Of course, Dr. Dre, as expected, and as most dermatologists expectedly, when it comes to fragrance in skincare, will raise attention and talk about all the risks for allergens, contact allergens, inside most fragrances classically used in the past and the present as well in skincare, which can, and Dr. Dre for the 1000th time on her channel, as expected, I respect her for that, highlights these risks which relate to contact dermatitis, to aggravated photosensitivity, so bad reactions to sun exposure while having high concentrations of fragrance on the skin, which apply even more so to sprayed fragrance under the sun than skincare, but still not entering any debate. But then Dr. Dre says something which I consider so wise, and I humble myself in front of such wisdom. So here, 2 minutes footage of that video. It is a lengthy video. The entire video is 27 minutes. Dr. Dre, 27 minutes. But I just fish out these 2 minutes, which I think are very, very revealing.
Does everybody develop a problem to fragrance who uses it indefinitely? No. What proportion of people do versus don't? I can't tell you. We don't actually have good data on that because of the nature of the system and the way that we test for the disease. So, you know, I really can't answer that, give you a concrete answer. But in my compartment as a dermatologist, I do see a lot of problems related to the use of fragrance and personal care products. So I have a duty to you guys to point that out, especially when people are coming to me asking me in my comments and whatnot, like, what do you think of this cream and that cream and this cream and that cream? I mean, the market is saturated. It's saturated with so many products at a variety of price points, you know, claiming X, Y, and Z. And a lot of times when I just look at the ingredient list, it's like, this is offering nothing but a ton of fragrance ingredients. So this is unlikely to help people. It's more likely to harm people. Plus it's super expensive, which is harmful for your financial health. So I'm gonna point those things out in my videos always to you guys. But it doesn't mean that, like, you know, fragrance is necessarily like something that we have to strictly avoid at all costs. I feel like when I point it out, some people are misled into thinking that like fragrance is bad, we must avoid. And that's like actually impossible to do. And as a matter of fact, people who have fragrance allergy, I mean, ask them, it's nearly impossible to avoid it completely. It is everywhere. So I'm not advocating that. I mean, I live and let live. And you know, if you want to bathe in Jean Nate, go ahead. But I am going to point out the fact that there are some risks with it. I will say this though, you guys, because I get questions like, why is it that some dermatologists don't seem to care about fragrance and you like are always pointing it out and you know others are always pointing it out? Why is it that some people in the skincare industry don't seem to think it matters whereas others do? And I'll tell you this straight up, we all have our biases, myself included. Major reason for that is that we all exist in compartments. In my compartment, I see primarily issues related to using fragrance and personal care products. Because guess what? Nobody comes to the dermatologist when their skin is fine and they're having a great, you know, they don't have any skin issues. I'm only going to be seeing people who have skin problems.
My turn to say something wise. The words you speak and the thoughts you think create your reality. I am amazed that Dr. Dre brings out this fact that we, from the compartment from which we have a professional perspective on topics, can represent a bias. And this bias is just human, and while being aware of it, it no longer carries too much burden because we can create a distance and not see the reality in black and white all the time. Because all those simplistic explanations, what's right, what's wrong, the do's and the don'ts, don't serve an intelligent adult way to approach skincare. That's why I always have this broken record in my content saying that you should not worry about the ingredient, the product, more than you worry about understanding how skin functions. Because if you understand how the skin functions, I will just put up another second of this video for another very interesting insight in terms of product claims.
There are a lot of products out there that are labeled fragrance-free, and it's becoming more and more of a thing. So I get it, like some people in the industry are probably frustrated with it because they see this happening with other things and, you know, like people developing loyalties to certain claims. And I've got to tell you guys, like I don't feel like a sense of warm fuzziness in my heart when I see the term fragrance-free on a product, because you have to be really careful about claims that brands and products are making. They're not regulated at all. Like, the last thing I want to do is create a boom of more products out there that are specifically labeled fragrance-free. I know that fragrance-free, that terminology, means nothing. Manufacturers, like I said, aren't required to disclose fragrance, and some ingredients have other functions in a product, so they can get away with putting fragrance in there and not really telling you about it.
Well said, Dr. Dre. You are so right. And it's so good that you say some people in the industry might feel frustrated, because I do. By the way, one of the ways to eventually claim fragrance-free, because not having in the inky list the words fragrance, parfum, which are regulated, it's actually essential oils. So I have the link here to the video I made before on essential oils, where you have all these listings, because essential oils, which might not be classified as fragrance, are fragrance. The reason why Dr. Dre, dermatologists, and so many people talk negatively about fragrance in skincare, it's due to the fact that there are these natural occurring allergens. I also made a video about this, where I actually have a link where you can download all the contact allergens official list from the European community, so you can really check in all your ingredient lists not only the presence of fragrance, but whether there are those contact allergens present. I would love, Dr. Dre, to hear from you. I don't even know if you are acquainted, because this is almost not talked about in the industry, allergen-free fragrances. Fragrances built in the laboratory to contain no contact allergens which are detectable, meaning that those fractions are non-existing or existing at such low percentage, which they are not detectable, and because they are not detectable, they are not listed. And this is regulated, and there are minimums both for leave-on and rinse off products for what can be classified as allergen-free. So maybe this black and white between fragranced and fragrance-free, ignoring also the cloudy skies about what fragrance-free might mean, but this choice between black and white, it's probably very old news. Do you agree, Dr. Dre? I'm sure you don't agree because you are a dermatologist. As you say, you see it more from your compartment, and I'm sure you are right because your patients expect that from you. So my friendliest word of advice is that you get acquainted with the allergens which are mandatory to be listed in the ingredient list. So it's not true that brands can omit, they can hide those allergens as long as the allergens are present in those concentrations which are traceable. And even if you don't vote me for president, I hope that anybody listening to me votes me to say no to boring skincare and to say see you next time in the next video next week. Ciao! So now that I'm open to election campaign, why not to join the force and click on the bell, activate, click like, so we see each other next week.